Is this jar empty? I mean really empty? Before you answer, what if I told you that if you're wrong, you're technically violating the United States Code of Federal Regulations? That's the situation you'll find yourself in when you store containers that hold hazardous waste. I'm Roger with Lion Technology, and in this video, I'll tell you how to know when a hazardous waste container is really, truly empty according to the Resource Conservation and Recovery Act Hazardous Waste Regulations. So, we have a container, like a drum, that contains hazardous waste. That waste is subject to detailed requirements for management and storage, contingency planning, markings and labels, inspections, training personnel, and more under the RCRA regulations. Those regulations don't apply to empty containers, though. The question is, when is a container that seems empty really empty according to the regulation? Under RCRA, a container is considered empty only when two conditions are met. First, you removed as much waste as possible using industry practices like pouring, pumping, draining, suction, scraping, and so on. And second, no more than 1 inch of residue remains on the bottom of the container. In Lion's hazardous waste training, we refer to this as the 1 inch rule. The RCRA regulations treat three types of hazardous waste differently, and we'll touch on all three in just a minute. First, as an alternative to the 1 inch rule, you can use math to determine when a container is RCRA empty. For a container with a capacity of 119 gallons or less, like our drum, no more than 3% by weight of the container's capacity can be left inside after industry practices are used to remove as much as possible. So, if the container holds 100 pounds, there must be no more than 3 pounds of residue in it to be considered empty. For a container with a capacity more than 119 gallons, like a big IBC or tote, the ratio is 0.3% by weight of the container's capacity. I mentioned that EPA treats three types of hazardous waste differently. These are compressed gases, acute hazardous wastes, and hazardous waste pharmaceuticals. Let's take these one by one. A compressed gas container is empty when the pressure inside approaches atmospheric. That means the pressure inside is the same as the pressure outside. For a container that held an acutely hazardous waste to be RCRA empty, the container or the inner liner you remove from the container must be triple rinsed using a solvent capable of removing the product or chemical. You can use other methods, but the generator must prove through testing or scientific literature that their method is as effective as triple rinsing at removing the waste. The third type of waste that's treated differently are hazardous waste pharmaceuticals. We're not going to get into these specific rules in this video, but I'll say this. New standards for these wastes took effect a few years ago. You can find them in 40 CFR Part 266, Subpart P. There's a link to some resources about these rules in the video description, but in a nutshell, there are four standards for empty for four different types of containers here. One for dose containers like pill bottles, one for syringes, one for IV bags, and one for other containers including delivery devices like inhalers. One last thing to remember is that nearly every state in the US is authorized to run its own hazardous waste program. States must enforce hazardous waste regulations that are at least as strict as the federal rules and can impose more stringent requirements. So, it's important to check your state's rules before making decisions about compliance. So, now that we know our hazardous waste container is empty, it should be no problem to ship it out to be refilled, returned, or disposed of, right? Not so fast. For the most part, the RCRA regulations don't address transportation of hazardous waste. For those rules, we'll have to look to the U.S. Department of Transportation's Hazardous Materials Regulations, or HMR. And we'll do that in our next video. Spoiler alert, DOT standards for shipping empty packages are not the same as EPA's rules for containers. In fact, a package that contains residue of a hazardous waste or other hazardous material is subject to the same level of regulation as a full package most of the time. Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful or interesting, please use the like button, the share button, and all buttons not otherwise specified to help your colleagues and friends find it. Visit lion.com for training and resources to simplify compliance with the latest environmental, hazardous materials, and workplace safety regulations that impact your facility. And I'll see you next time.